Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back in the laboratory with more styrene addiction. One person who is new to the channel suggested that we do a kind of, what would be the word? Kind of, you know, going back and looking at the beginning and, you know, following through all the way to now and see what we've done, what we've learned, what we've got. And what we've got here is failure to have more fun. Actually, that's not true. Let me just put, Hey, we're making, that happens all the time. Not a big deal. We'll set it back in there. But let me start with an earlier model, way early. This is, and let me remove this. This is a model that was very easy to put together because to begin with, it has very few parts, and so we did it buck stock, and it was a lot of fun. And you know, we did some of the detailing. We drilled out the holes on the pipes, and we had quite a bit of fun with it. And used rattle can to paint it, and added some decals. I'm just wiping a little bit of the dust because it's been sitting on the inside shelves there for a while. But that's pretty much it. We added some decals, and we added some. Let's see if we can get it back in there. Yes, of course. There we go. So it very easy, but you know, this was back in the day when we were just sort of you know, doing box stock, simple builds, a little bit of detailing, a little bit of graphical work, and you know, it brought us a lot of pleasure. And and the decal is lifting up over here. Oh, look, it lifted up so much it came off. That's okay. We'll remove it with the, falling apart. That tells you how long it's been. That decal was brittle and it had separated. With a little bit of tape, we'll put it on there and remove it. So, you know, not a big deal. So, yeah, so a little bit of tape helped right away to clean up the spot, and then we'll add something else. And then we, of course, put the little hood ornament back. So this was basically built, I don't know exactly how long ago, but it easily over 10 years ago that we built this. And then, you know, we did a lot of this kind of models for quite a while, and you know, learn a little bit about paint, about detailing, about incorporating graphics, and making sure that there's a variety of you know, metallized paint just to create, again, interest. Then one day we and from this point to this point, we're looking at maybe 5 years or so, and we started thinking about finally using the airbrush. And so this was one of our very first airbrush jobs. Let me move this out of the way so that I can handle, you know, a Binky barbecue. We used some rub-on letterings, and you could tell because they are basically, you know, peeling off here. I guess the temperature has something to do with it, but that's okay. It's all part of the fun of having, you know, a model this long and for this long. It's gotten a little bit dusty here and there, so we have to repair. You know, we have to clean it up. We started using the airbrush and we went crazy. And the idea for this just came simply one day when we found the pig at the hobby shop. You know, I should move this back over here a little bit. And which is fine because it wants to roll towards the neck and leave like an imprint of you know, when it was originally painted. It's pinned onto the hood, so that's why it moves a little bit. I could easily take it off. But anyway, back to the story. So we airbrushed a lot of this and, you know, weathered it, fell in love with the possibilities of using the airbrush and all of that good stuff. You know, at this point, we didn't know how to control any of it. We didn't know that we can mix different techniques to achieve different things. We were still very tentative, very green with the airbrush. But we knew the potential, we liked it. And so we started doing more and more builds of this sort and weathering a little bit. By this point, I think we were already using the salting technique, which here is used subtly. And this was a few years later that we did this build, this 41 Willis, where we cut off the top, we chopped the windshield down, cut the glass as well, then started to add all sorts of details, including watch parts. I mean, we already had the watch parts back over here, Cranky's Gold, so we started experimenting with upholstering, in this case, with a cigar box cedar veneer, and did a little bit of that. And we wanted to do something a little bit more extreme with the salt. So we were doing all kinds of crazy stuff. We were also learning to do some lettering and adding again airbrush work that graphic stuff that we were having fun with. And then we were also hand lettering stuff, very realistic, the way that somebody would put, you know, married, or, you know, in this case, if you can read this, you are shit out of luck. So, and then boo-hoo, just having a blast, basically. And again, using the airbrush and having a good time with it. And detailing, again, based on what parts came in the kit, you know, and then just embellishing here and there wherever we could, especially in the engine. And then, of course, now this is one of the latest that you've seen me build. And here we've gone all out, with, again, a lot of airbrush work, very tedious, but a lot of fun airbrush work, where we just airbrush everything. And then we use techniques like salting and sponging and dry brushing and washes and, you know, you name it, just to make sure that we get all kinds of neat layers in the finish. So, you know, and again, using watch parts, using mesh, using parts from the parts bin, and having a regular blast with it. So you see, you know, it,